I mean, that's what we had at the beginning of this year. We had this whole thing of divine arrangement. God is arranging the order of heaven. And in this year of 2010, and where it even with, you know, the whole thing with 10, we looked at here, which really ties in with what God's been speaking here.
Yeah.
The whole thing of 10 is like the 10 commandments. It was to bring a community into a place of order under God, in order to go and live in the promise.
And John 10:10, which is the life that's abundant. And you can't have an abundant life unless you have an abundant community, unless you have a community that understands who they are and what they're, how to
that
operate.
That is good.
And so Jesus said, I've called you to life and life abundance. And that means life that's exceedingly above what you could ever experience without him. But also, one of the definitions of that I love, that you'll love and the viewers will love, is that an abundant life in the Bible means more than everyone has everywhere else. That's one of the Greek meanings of abundant life, more than everyone has everywhere else.
Before we go on, why don't you just release that?
I'd love to.
Release it Holy Spirit, over the people watching.
We do. We release the abundance of life for 2010. Huh. John 10:10 in 2010. Yeah. We pray right now that there would be so much life. I call you to a full measure of life. Every area, whether it's finances, relationships, ministry opportunities, business opportunities, whatever is lacking, we say there's not just only enough, there's more than enough. There's more than enough that you're a person who lives under the kingdom, and that's your dominion.
Yeah.
That you don't live under recession, you don't live under relational poverty, you don't live under any of these things, that your ceiling is the kingdom of heaven, which is Jesus. And so we release life right now. That's good.
Yeah.